Good afternoon, everyone. How are you guys? This is a critical time. The world is facing the coronavirus attack, and everyone is staying home to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. So during this lockdown period, I thought I could create some more videos on AWS and probably the important thing on people want to learn. So a lot of people has asked me to create a tutorial on installing MySQL server on Amazon EC2 instance. So I'm going to create this now. So first I'm going to go to my running instances. Then there is no running instances here. I'm going to create a new one with Amazon Linux 1. As you know, this is my favorite Linux distro, but you can choose your own. The commands will be different for different versions. Let's select one and then we stay free tier. Next, keep as it is. Add storage, 8 gigs, fine. Tags, I'm not going to add some tags, and create a new security group, that's fine. IP, anywhere, I just need to open another port, HTTP. HTTPS, usually I do that, HTTPS. Okay, then review and launch. I'm going to create a new key pair here, MySQL. I'm going to download that key pair and create a launch instance. Great. Okay, while it's launching, I need to create a PPK file. So let's open Putigen. Putigen is a tool that you can use to generate the PPK file. So I'm going to load the PEM file, which I have just downloaded now. MySQL.pem file, and then we save the private MySQL server. That's fine. Our PPK file has been generated. That's good. Then I need to get the public IP of that instance, and then I'm going to connect to that instance. PuTTY. The user is EC2 user, then public IP. I give it a name, MySQL server. And then I choose the PPK file. I save it and I open this. Great, now I have connected to my instance. Just a minute, it's connecting. Yeah, it's connected. That's great. So I just want to run sudo yum -y. No patches updated. Okay, then sudo yum install MySQL. I'm going to install 5.7 and then server. Sorry, okay, it is going to install MySQL 5.7. So, yes, it is installing. Just a moment. So it has been installed. Then sudo service mysqlt start Okay, it has been started. Then I need to sudo service. It is the command that I need to set to start it on every time it reboots. So it is chconfig. Not copy that. Copy. Oh yeah, it is pasted. Chconfig, chconfig MySQL D on. This will reboot. This will start the MySQL server when server reboots. Okay. Then I'm going to run the secure installation. Validate password plugin, no, not required. New password, I'm just going to give a new password. Remove anonymous users, yes. Disallow root login remotely, yes. Remove test database, yes. Yes. Okay, all done. I just need to restart the database. Then I need to connect to the database. Oops, sorry. MySQL minus U, which is root. To give the password. Okay, my database has been connected, and then show databases. Perfect. So this is, as you can see, it's a simple way to connect to create a new EC2 instance and then use it as a database server. So this can be helpful if you are migrating existing database from on-premise and the version is not supported in the RDS. So this can help you to back up your database and then keep everything up there. So let me log out from the EC2 instance. And then my job is done, so I'm going to terminate the instance. Well, that's it. You see, it's less than 10 minutes and you created your separate server with MySQL running over there, and you can now create a new web server and connect to that database server, or you can actually install your web server onto that server as well. Okay, anything you can do after that. This was my tutorial on how you can install MySQL server on EC2. It is a easy and cheap way to set up MySQL server on Amazon. RDS is sometimes a bit expensive, but you can use it easy to set up your MySQL server. Okay, so thank you for watching my video and have a nice